morning, everyone. It's Monday Live with MJ and Mr. Hermes, your source of good news, where we start our week in a brighter side. So it's been a few months since we have been in quarantine, and it's great news. We finally are able to go out in our park. Look at this beautiful park. And Sean will show you how our beach looked like on Memorial Day today. And it's very heartwarming to know that finally we could see greens here and walk. So all we can do right now is walk and do some exercises, but no recreational dances. So our dances will be available with you when we're home. My message today is in really respect and honoring our heroes, our war heroes who fought for our freedom. So it's Memorial Day weekday today. It's Monday. And one historical fact I wanted to share with you is that it used to be May 30th that we celebrate Memorial Day, because a lot of people will decorate the graveyards of their loved ones who died during Civil War back in 1800s. And people and a lot of countries saw this like how people pray and at the same time offer flowers. So finally, in 1971, our government approved a federal holiday to honor our war heroes. And who else are our war heroes? So in addition to them, right now our caregivers are our war heroes, along with our doctors, nurses, and scientists who are actively doing the war heroes and get us out of this, free us from this pandemic. We have our caregivers, we have our cleaners here in Santa Monica, because all people love Santa Monica, all people love to walk here, but who is responsible, who take the risk of their health and their life to clean this? So we will have a war hero of today's world to be featured in our Monday Live today, available in YouTube.
We're here today celebrating Memorial Day. Here on Monday, Memorial Day, we're at Santa Monica. They opened the beaches up, and you can see it's a little bit different than last year. Last year there were thousands of people here. Now there's 40, 50. And we really want to celebrate those people who have obviously died in the, you know, the wars, celebrating them who, you know, protected us and keep our freedoms. But we also want to celebrate those heroes that are still alive today, doing the same thing in the hospitals, first responders, police, fire, all the people, the grocery stores, anybody who's a hero to you. And hero could be a lot of things, you know, in the spiritual side or the emotional side. We're always talking about family members that are role models or heroes. You know, my grandfather, he was in the military, and he, you know, defended our country, but he also was married to his wife for 50 years plus. So that's something that we can always celebrate and admire as well. People who do outstanding things in our family or our friends or our relatives that are extraordinary.
Hey everyone, this is the hero of today's world. He is the one responsible for the beauty of our park. Every morning gets up at 4 a.m. and really make it clean. Look at this, guys. This is why we enjoy life here in Santa Monica. Our hero, Mr. Alex.
Hello.
So Alex has a really big dream, since he's gonna tell you about it, like his goals in the next 7 years, you know.
Oh, well, I have a couple of dreams. Hopefully maybe move up here in the city of Santa Monica, in the city. If not, I'm gonna keep working, and hopefully one day I have my own dump place. Recycle tree, dirt, topsoil. So hopefully those are my goals. So let's see what happens for the next 7 years.
And that'll make everything better around here.
Yes, that's my plan.
That'll improve all the landscaping, that'll improve the environment.
Yes. Yes, and also I want to give people chances in life too, who are looking for work. So I'm all about the people.
We've actually known Alex for what, about a year now?
Yeah.
Coming here, we see him every morning we come here. He's always here working so hard, and listen to that. He has a dream. He has a 7-year plan of making our environment even better. And so how do you go about doing that?
Save your money.
Yeah, but is it small steps?
Yes, baby steps. I'm taking baby steps. Not spending as much like I used to. And then just working hard.
And declaring it.
Yeah.
Like now you're on camera, so you got to do it.
Yeah.
It's like anytime you call it out and declare that I'm going to do something, it kind of gives you a little more power. Like I do have to do it because now everyone knows I have to do it.
Yes.
So that's amazing.
Because I know before it was like I told you guys, it was a struggle before. Past maybe 10 years ago, working dead end jobs, making $80 a day. So I had bills, helping my parents out. And I was only left with my paycheck like $150, $100.
And you also have a lot of people to rely on you.
Yes.
So that does that give you more incentive?
Yes, because my goal is I just don't want to see my family struggling. So
I think that's the important goal of a lot of people.
And I always, I always wanted to be an actor when I was a kid, but I think at least not for me. So I think God, God put me a place to help someone, to help people out.
If you're gonna have a successful business, you might need some successful commercials on TV.
Yeah.
You gotta be the face of that.
Yeah, that's so true. So
you might be that person in entertainment.
Hopefully one day. So I'm looking forward and
great
the challenge.
Well, thank you so much, for all your hard work out
thank
here.
You.
Thank you for spending time with us.
Thank you.
We always love your stories and how's it going, guys? We were showing you and focusing and showcasing different ways financially we can get ahead, help your businesses, help you get ahead with your business expenses and your savings and things like that. And it's kind of hard to tie into Memorial Day. We're really trying to talk about how are we celebrating those people who have lost their lives in wars, or how are the people that either lost their lives helping us fight this pandemic. So one of the things we can talk about is legacy. How are we leaving a legacy for our families? A lot of the people who have lost their lives, maybe they didn't actually lose just their lives. Maybe they left something of gold to their family. Maybe they left a legacy. Maybe it was a cookbook. Maybe everyone in their family has that special cookbook that no one will get a copy of until somebody passes away. Maybe it's the deed to an estate or a house that's beautiful. Maybe it's a sum of money that can help future generations. Whatever it is, talk to somebody, talk to us. We can help you set up legacies like that. We talk to nonprofits. We work with these people because we want to actually help pass on not just wealth, not just generational wealth, but pass on memories. Today is about memories, and we're trying to be sovereign. We're trying to be, solemn with what we're talking about, because it's not just about money. It's not just about fun, entertainment. People are at the beach, yeah, but we're really about the solemnness of how can we make the future better? How can we make the lives of people better? So that's one thing we're going to look at today. We're going to reflect on, always have your gratitude and, enjoy this beautiful weather. It's beautiful out here. Love it. So we'll talk to you soon.
It's dance time to finish our Roomba advanced class.
Mejor para que terminar más mal. Mejor decir fue bueno hasta aquí. Mejor pensar te volveré a encontrar. Seré feliz al vernos sonreír.